Hi guys, this is Brian Kosterman from Eindhoven, part of the APCO group in the events division. Welcome to the Cycle of Development Stage 3. Congratulations. This is right here, section B, about personal recruitment. It's really important that you know the why, because of personal recruitment. Apologize for my English, by the way. I just got an English dictionary. I just give it a go. It's really important for the growth in your own business. When you bring in a lot of people, you got more chance to expand your business, to expand your team. And that's what I think everybody wants when they just become leader. And you can show your team how to take control of their own situation, of their own growth in the team and the growth of the whole office. So that's really good. Let's start with it from day one. What's the purpose? You have more fun people, you have more sharp people. You have more fun in the office, and that will help everything, I think. It will benefit you in more ways. First point, your team will grow and you can take control of the situation. The second one, the numbers tell us that the retention of personal recruits is a lot higher than people who come in from PRing. People will become leader easier, and they can help grow your office and your team. In a lot of countries, I'm not sure if it's everywhere, there's a PR bonus and it will benefit you, so you earn some extra euros. And if you are smart, you will reinvest it in your teams with a little drink, a little dinner, some fun things. And that will be better for the retention of the guys, I think, and for the growth of your team. You can do the PRing at some different ways. I always do it in the field. I'm not only setting a PR goal. I'm not only setting a sales goal, but I'm setting a PR goal as well. I started from day one. When new people come in, they have to know it's a habit. That's PRing is part of the business. Always look for people who are willing to work. Always look for people who are willing to make a career. And always look for people who you like and who probably like you then as well. After every positive or fun conversation in the field, I just give it a go. Hey, by the way, we're always looking for fun, sharp people who are looking for a job as well. How about you? I used a lot of impulses. I first lost people. I'm like, hey, I will try. Maybe we have some space for you. I hope. I keep my fingers crossed, but I will help you out. I'm quite indifferent when I ask about how is the money, how are the hours. I'm like, if you are willing to work hard, you can make some good money, but it's all up to you. I'm not overselling the business, because I think that it's working the wrong way instead of the right way. And I always use the feel-good factor, because people just, they like to get compliments. Wow, you have very nice shoes, by the way. You look very sharp. You just got a haircut. People like it, and they start like you more, and they come in easier for a presentation or an appointment. And I show the passion about the work. I tell a little bit about the vision. I'm not telling them, you can open 25 offices and you go there and there and there. But just a little bit of passion that you're quite ambitious and that they can be part of it. And then they're like, that's maybe something I will try. It's more than I thought. And always tell them about the customer service bit. That we're not students, that we're not those touchy salesmen, but that we are good salespeople. We have a good customer service, because I think that will make sure the retention is better. What I always do when I have a PR someone, I'm not just giving a card to someone, hey, maybe can you book them in for me. I always do it myself. I call them the same evening because they are fresh in mind and they remember me. To be honest, 8 of the 10 people I book in, they come to a presentation or an appointment, because I think I follow this structure. This is what happens. If you do it, your team will grow, the fun will go up, the sales will go up, the money will go up, more promotions will happen, and we have more fun in the office, and that's what everybody wants, I think. It's really copyable if you start with it from day one. People will see it as a habit, and your team will grow. Nothing can stop you. Thanks for listening.